Today we are troubleshooting a voltage leak on a 2002 Chevy Cavalier. I'm just going to do a quick run through of the troubleshooting steps that are involved with troubleshooting any voltage leak on any vehicle. The most common problems when you're having a slow voltage leak are that when you go to start your car after it's been sitting for a long time, it won't start up, you won't have enough power to start, or your battery may even be completely dead. And depending on how bad the leak is, it might be overnight even, so the car is nearly undrivable. When you're troubleshooting this problem, you're just going to need a few simple tools. You're going to need a multimeter. I picked up this Innova 3220 for less than $30 at Walmart. And it's automatically ranging and has an amp meter on it, which is what we need for this particular test. And a trickle charger. If you take your battery to AutoZone or whatever, they'll trickle charge it for you and test it. You definitely want to test to make sure that your battery's good, because that's the most common problem is your battery's bad and you don't actually have a voltage leak. So I have a regular trickle charger, and I charged up the battery and got it in here. We want to make sure that we have a completely charged battery so that we aren't having low voltage because the battery's weak. We want to make sure that we've got regular draw from a good battery. And the process is very straightforward. First, you connect your multimeter to the fuse circuit. Most multimeters will have a 10 amp fuse circuit that's used to gauge amps versus the regular voltage and resistance circuit that's used when you're usually using a multimeter to test for continuity or something like that. And we're just gonna fire it up. Then we're going to switch to DC 10 amp. And as you can see, what I've done here is I have disconnected the battery terminal from the battery, and then I've installed my two test probes here using alligator clips to make sure we've got a good connection there. And really, this is a two-person job, because you're going to want to have one person keeping an eye on your current reading here and one other person running through systems in the car. So we have this whole setup hooked up here, and what you might then do is go to the fuse box in your car, which on this car is installed just to the left of the steering wheel, and just start pulling fuses one at a time until your current drops, and then you know that one is the culprit. In this case, I was measuring a current of 0.8 amps until I removed the cluster fuse. And that can be a little complicated, because after doing further research, I initially thought that there was an issue with the cluster. There's little servos and a couple different lights in there that could, you know, have some kind of small short to ground or something like that. But after doing some research, I was not able to find anyone else that had any problems with the cluster on this particular vehicle. And also, the cluster is needed in order to power on the vehicle or engage the BCM to unlock doors, and it's also connected to the ABS module. So there's many different systems that are connected to that system, so it doesn't necessarily point to a cause. In your case, the most common culprits are going to be an aftermarket wired system, audio system, or any kind of aftermarket electronic installed system, like a radar detector or a cell phone charger or something along those lines. Anytime the factory did not install it, that's your most common culprit for a voltage leak. So in this case, I did some initial troubleshooting on the vehicle. I wasn't really satisfied with the results of that troubleshooting, and then I came back and troubleshot it once again, and this time I'm getting very different results, because as you can see, once I close the door and that dome light powers off, right now it's reading almost an amp. And that is the most common problem when you're trying to troubleshoot these issues, is you might have a hood light or a dome light or something like that. You want to unplug those lights and make sure they're not polluting your results. But as you'll see in just a second here, it's going to drop down to 0.77 amps, which is a perfectly acceptable draw for a modern car that has a remote entry system or anything like that. So whatever is going on here, whatever draw is causing this battery to die is an intermittent problem, which makes it a lot more difficult to troubleshoot, of course, but that's going to be my problem, not yours. One final note, when you first connect this, also notice that it may take quite a while for your car's computer and other systems to charge and power on. So we'll disconnect this. It's going to drop down to 0 amps. Then we're going to connect it. There's a little spark there. And you see it goes up to 1.2 amps, 1 amp, 0.9 amps as it's powering everything up, charging everything up, booting up the car's computer. And then for your car, it may take, you know, maybe 10 or 15 minutes for everything to power up, depending on your particular vehicle. For this Cavalier, it's just a minute or so for everything to boot up, and then you get back down to your acceptable reading. Anything over, I would say, probably 200 milliamps or something like that would be considered an excessive drain, and you'd want to look for some kind of voltage leak somewhere in your vehicle. Anything less than that, and maybe your battery just isn't fully charged, maybe you have a dead battery, but that's the basic process, is just hook up a multimeter in series with your car battery to the battery terminal. Make sure that you're measuring amps in the correct manner. Make sure you're hooked up to your fused 10-amp terminal on your multimeter. And then pulling fuses and trying to troubleshoot what system it is that's pulling voltage from your battery. There you go. If you have any questions, feel free to post them, and I'll do whatever I can to help you.